years later, with Zinbel's parting words still haunting her, the darkness came back with a vengeance. A plague.
Tony?
Everyone suffered.
My father was not supposed to die like this.
Senua, the suffering you've caused.
This is your fault. You brought this plague to us. You have blood on your hands.
They're coming for you now.
They're coming.
To get you. Hold your heavy strike.
Hold it.
Hold the heavy strike.
Hold it. Hold your heavy strike.
Unleash the sword.
She can't remember.
How does it focus?
The corpse waved through itself over the ones I loved. The ship broke up under them. The ship that had sailed from the land of shining fields. Their memorial stone is sacred. Come not here in the sun. Come not with a sword. Come not crying over a naked corpse. Come not with disturbed mind.
Do you hear the suffering, Senua? Does your precious gift of sight let you see the souls that rot here in this sea of corpses? Do you feel the blood running cold on your skin? Do you hear their endless cries? Do you smell their putrid wounds? They were once brothers, sisters, and loved ones. And look at what you have done to them. All because you were a coward, because you ran from your curse instead of facing it. When you turned your back on your father, Zinbel, you turned your back on the gods and let the darkness wreak havoc on your people. Why must they pay for your heresy? Senua. Go to her. Answer her pitiful call.
Darkness took her life, and it will take yours. It's taking you.
Mama! I need you! Help me!
You're both dead. You both surrendered to the voices.
And your dear beloved mother was powerless against the darkness when it came for her. She too had a sight. She too doubted the gods and let the darkness infest her. But she didn't run. She escaped the only way she knew how. She gave her life to the gods.
If only you had done the same, the world would have been spared this horror.
It's not too late. She's calling for you. Why don't you join her?
Thank you.
still fight on. Maybe you too should suffer with your brethren in this rot and let your blood seep into the seas of the rivers of hell. Isn't that what you deserve after all you've done? Give the darkness what it wants, let it swallow your soul and destroy all that you are. Why are you fighting for someone who is already dead? Just look around you. What hope was there for him, even if his soul could be rescued? Do you think he'd thank you for what you have done to him, to his friends, and to his father?
Anymore. Not on my own. Where are you, Mother? I want to be with you.
That night, she gave up on her world to follow in the footsteps of her mother, to go to a place where the darkness couldn't reach her.
Senua, look at me.
Do you hear them? They're calling for me.
We've lost so many. And I've lost my father. I can't lose you.
You said it. I have blood on my hands.
I didn't say that. You've done nothing wrong.
Zimbal was right. Everyone will suffer.
Zimbal is a fake. He is a hateful, bitter liar. He's poison. And his words still haunt you. Who do you trust? Him? Or me? Do you still believe in me, Senua? In us? Come back to me. Don't let this darkness come between us.
The hardest battles are fought in the mind. He gave her the sword with which to fight in more ways than one. She gave him her word, never to surrender. she needed was a little help. A little hope.
Into the mountain.
Can you see it?
Shall we tell her where to go?
It's not far. Go on.
Look up.
Just up there. Listen to us. Sit. Shall we?
Does she know which way to look? Does she know her way into the mountain?
She's a girl, isn't she?
There's a door.
You can do it.
You can see it.
Come on, Senua.
Go away. I'm not listening.
I will tell you of a great hero named Sigurd, son of Sigmund, no less. Born after his father's death, Sigurd is cared for by the dwarf, Rein. But Rein does not love the boy. Instead, he plans to use him for his own ends. You see, Rein's father possessed a great treasure given to him by the gods. But Rein's brother, Fafnir, killed his father and took the gold all for himself. Fafnir hid the treasure out on a heath and could not leave it. And from the evil in his heart, he turned into a dark creature. A dragon.
Thank you. Can you feel it?
She can feel it.
No.
Don't open the door.
No, go in.
Turn back. Turn back.
What's it like?
Get back. A great beast guards Helheim. Garm is its name. And it knows you are here, Senua. It can smell your stink. What are you afraid of, Senua? How would you say Dillion if you are too much of a coward to step into the shadow?
They can't stop me.
Then do it. The beast is stalking you from the shadows. Your sword is useless here. Don't fall for it.
It's me, Senua.
It's so loud.
It's not her.
So full of hate.
It's a plan.
I just want to help them.
Tell me what to do.
Your father wants them to go away. And he only hurts me to silence them.
But he's gone now.
But they always come back. He says I will die if I go with them. They want me with them.
Stop!
That's why they crawl through the walls.
Don't listen.
Do you
to them.
See them? Do you see their faces?
He's coming! Senua! Help me! Help! Get me out of here! Don't go!
Where is she gone? She's disappeared again.
She shouldn't be here. She escaped the darkness. She took her own life to escape it.
She can't remember when it started. When her mother lost her smile. Her eyes gazing past her towards a world she could not see. This is what happens if you reach for the underworld, he said. It was a lot to take in for a child. And the first time she felt the cold chill of fear. I don't talk much about her father, Zinbel. I suppose I just didn't want to risk upsetting her. But it doesn't matter now, does it?
Please. She'll have to go under.
She can't.
She has to.
She can't.
The torch will come out.
Don't.
We don't.
She can't. Come out.
She can do it.
She can't do it.
The light's gone out. What? Run. Get through it as quick as you can. The panic is here.
Rain the dwarf's sole desire is to possess this dragon's accursed treasure, and he uses Sigurd to reclaim it. He tells Sigurd the story of Fafnir's gold, and the good-hearted hero promises to slay the dragon if Rain would forge a strong sword for him. Sigurd remembers that his father once possessed a sword given to him by Odin. Odin broke the sword to bring about Sigmund's death, but Sigurd's mother still has the pieces. And so Rain reforges the famous sword. Sigurd uses the sword first to avenge his father, and then he and Rain go in search of Fafnir. Sigurd learns that Brynhild had once disobeyed Odin, and so he had her punished, stuck her with a sleep thorn, and put her body within a rampart of burning shields. Only a man who knew no fear would ever reach her. But like me, Sigurd is fearless and passes through the flames, just as I did, and wakes the sleeping warrior girl. She teaches him the secret wisdom of runes, namely victory runes, ship runes, runes for persuasion, runes for truth, runes for healing and help, runes for perception and power. Like Sigurd, the greatest young warrior of the North, you must learn the secrets of the runes. gods, to fight amongst the gods in hell.
Reminds her of the isolating, suffocating darkness that she lived through as a young girl. Imprisoned in her room at night, the faces in the dark, coming through the walls. She once thought everyone could see them. I mean, that's what children say all the time, isn't it? That there are monsters in the dark. By the time she realized that only she could see them, her father, Zinbel, could see the monster in her.
Sweet.
is crawling into your mind, searching for weakness. It found your mother and used her to trap you in here.
Did you see her die? I don't remember. I was only 5. They told me she escaped the darkness, that she's with the gods. But what if they lied? What if the darkness took her and trapped her here?
It's a trap. The beast is coming. Sleeping beneath me.
Run away from me! We let you have nothing!
Now it can see you at your weakest. The time you suffered as a child at the hands of your father Zindo while you pined for Dillion. Do you remember the darkness, Senua? The beast is bringing it back.
Did you leave me? This darkness, it's spreading. Father's keeping me away from the others, away from Tilly. I won't give up. I'm not going to rot in here. I'm going to find Dillion.
Zinbel was trying to save her from the darkness. But she wouldn't herself. And now everybody is dead.
Because of her.
It's all her fault.
All her fault. So weak. She should have known. She should have.
Why doesn't she learn? Why does she learn? Now the darkness has Dillian's.
And it will take it and never give it back.
She can search and search, but she will never find
it. She's let the darkness in. It's the end.
The darkness will take her like it took her mother.
She can't resist. Pointless even trying to retrieve it. She's lost.
Where is she going? She's got to go deeper to find the head. Deeper towards the darkness.
The beast is there. Beast is luring her deeper, deeper into the darkness. Deep, deep down.
The beast has the head.
She's got the head. She will be trapped.
The beast has the head and he's using it.
Once she gets down there, she'll never come out. It's luring her down.
The darkness will take her like it took her mother.
Deeper and deeper. The beast knows. The beast knows exactly where she is. She's falling for it.
She falls for their tricks every time.
Plays into his hands.
The darkness is coming. Where is it going? She was just a trick.
The dragon Fafnir is so large and deadly that it would be impossible to kill him face to face. But each day, Fafnir crawls across the heath to find water. So Sigurd digs a pit in the dragon's path and lies in wait in it. When Fafnir slithers overhead, Sigurd sinks his sword into the dragon up to the hilt. Sigurd leaps from the pit, and Fafnir sees his killer. He warns Sigurd that the treasure will lead to his death, as it led to the death of Ragnar. Sigurd replies that death comes to all men, and every man would want to be wealthy until that day. And he takes the treasure.
Where is she now?
The darkness killed your mother.
Where is she now? Where is she?
She's looking to her. The darkness will kill you.
The darkness took your mother and it will take you.
Eventually. What really happened to her?
Your mother was weak like you are. Her mother was weak like she is.
So weak.
The darkness took her and it will take Senua too.
It's just a matter of time. Just let the darkness in. Let it take her. You've got to be stronger. Just like her mother. She's got to.
What if this is another trick?
What's she doing?
She's lighting.
She's making light. She's making a fire.
She's got light on the other side.
She'll be safe. What's her plan? What's she thinking? How's she going to get there?
Although Sigurd kills the dragon, Rayan wants to keep Fafnir's gold all for himself. Rayan also wants the strength and wisdom of the dragon, so he drinks its blood and asks Sigurd to roast Fafnir's heart for him. Sigurd does so, but when he touches the roasted heart to see if it is done, he burns his finger. Without thinking, he licks his finger and tastes the dragon's blood. In that moment, he understands the language of birds and hears them talk nearby.
Make it.
Stop the secret.
can't help but think of him. A tender guiding flame in a world so black. The longer it burned, the more she convinced herself that there was nothing beyond its reach. How little separates us from what we fear.
Sigurd's newfound power lets him hear the birds speak, and they say Sigurd should eat the heart himself.
Keep looking for Dillian.
Rian wants Fafnir's gold. Sigurd should kill Rian before Rian kills him.
Use it now. She's going too slow. Dillian is so close.
Sigurd should find Brynhild the Valkyrie, who sleeps an enchanted sleep.
Dillian.
Sigurd heeds the bird's advice. He kills Rian, eats Fafnir's roasted heart, and takes Fafnir's treasure. And he embarks on a new quest. To ride to Hinderfell and find Brynhild, the Valkyrie.
Yeah.
People think of evil as an unnatural, invisible force, and so invoke the gods for protection. But evil can come from the hand behind the gods. A familiar hand, cold and cruel. He tried to fix her with his rituals, kept her trapped in that hole. She couldn't say which was worse. The darkness. Or the monster that her father had become. She couldn't fight them both. And so she left. Headed for the one ray of light that shone down on her. If she had stayed, she wouldn't have survived. Maybe Delian would still be alive.
I'm so sorry, my love.
She will save his soul. Even if this time, she can't save her own.